Welcome, you masterpiece. This is Masterpiece.
Bars.
And we are in the living room today. Yeah. And you, no matter where you are, this is your living room. So from our living room to your living room, we welcome you. We want you to worship the Lord God with us. And we'll do that together. And my very best friend is going to lead us in worship.
Come on, best friend.
Come on, best friend.
We're going to have a good time today.
Yeah.
Amen. Let's get into it. Yeah. Wherever you are, you can clap your hands. You can rock with us. Come on. This one.
Say, oh, oh,
oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh,
everybody say,
oh, 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 oh.
The song says,
darkness seems to be all around me, searching for what my eyes cannot see. Where to go next, and who can I trust? No one but your Jesus. Say, I can see the light. Yeah, I can see the light coming. Say, I can see the light. I can see the light. Say, whoa,
oh, oh, oh,
come on.
Oh,
that's your part right there. Say, whoa,
oh, oh,
whoa,
oh, oh, oh.
Again, it says,
darkness seems to be all around me, searching for what cannot see. Where to go next, and who can I trust? No one but your, my hope is Jesus. I can see the light, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can see the light.
your light on us.
Thank you.
Shine your light, Jesus. Oh, shine your light on us. Shine your light, Jesus. 'Cause this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, yeah, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine.
This little light.
Our prayer today, Father,
yes, Lord,
that in everything that we do, we represent you. That when people see us in this earth, they see you.
Yes.
No, we're not perfect people, but Father, we thank you that your spirit, your love makes the difference. So we worship you now in this moment. And we just say thank you for being everything that we need. We thank you for being our life, our love. And you're so worthy of all the praise. So if you don't mind, just take your quick moment wherever you are and just find you a space to lift your hands and, as my son would say, practice calmness. Man. And just breathe. Because he's worthy of every song that we could ever sing. He's worthy. He's worthy of your hallelujahs. He's worthy of your hands lifted. So we give you another day. We give you praise today. Oh, worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. We live for you. Jesus, the only name that could ever save. Jesus, the only name that's above all names. We live for you. Free me to know.
worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live. Jesus, the only name above every other name. Jesus, the only name that could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Everybody sings, yeah. Holy,
there is no one God.
Talk like you, wanna laugh like you.
wanna love like Jesus. Wanna love like Jesus. I wanna love like you, Jesus. I wanna love like you, Jesus. So fill me up, God, till I overflow. Help us run over and over. We surrender all.
God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you, as in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory. Because your steadfast love is better than life, my lips will praise you. So I will bless you as long as I live. In your name, I will lift up my hands. My soul will be satisfied as with fat and rich food, and my mouth will praise you with joyful lips. When I remember you upon my bed and meditate on you in the watches of the night, for you have been my help.
Oh, hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome to the living room, MPC in the place to be. That's wherever you are right now. We're with you and you with me. Those are like bars right there. But thank you for pulling up to the Jordan's house. We are honored to be with you today from our living room to your living rooms. If this is your first time joining us virtually, we want to say welcome home.
Welcome home.
We are grateful to share this time together in the virtual space. You might be with your kinfolk. You might be posted up in one of our host homes across the nation. Thank you. We see y'all. Thank you for viewing this together. Maybe you're gathered together on a military base or maybe on a college campus, traveling on the road. I know people on movie sets, professional athletic facilities. You could be in a hospital right now. You could be on lockdown. No matter where you are, MPC is glad to meet you right where you are right now. So do us a favor. Let us know where you're at and who you're with so our leaders can show you some love. Somebody say, put it in the chat.
Put it in the chat.
If you have a Bible with you or an electronic device, in a couple of moments, we're going to be reading from Colossians 3. And although, hey, we love you, so we're putting the scriptures and the points. It's all going to be easily accessible on the screen for you. But we always encourage you to hold the word of God in your own hands. And so while you're locating Colossians, take a moment. Get comfy. As you can see, mi casa es su casa. Help yourself to whatever's in the fridge. Maybe have a refreshing Celsius. I'm joking. this is running, Joe, whatever. But listen, we are comfortable here in the living room. You can see the animal slippers, fuzzy socks, dope sneakers. This is the living room, and this is the place where we come. Yeah, I don't have those. I don't have those right there. Just super glad to take a moment. I want you to meet some of our friends, some of our MPC leaders. We got good family members. We got friends. We got a host home from Missouri. Yeah, that's right. Joyce, Tom, welcome. We're so glad that, you know, we met them or they met us, how some of y'all have met us in the virtual space. They just kind of stumbled upon it. And now we get an opportunity to do life together, not just here together, but wherever you are. We get to do life from our living room to your living room. So thank y'all for what you do in your living room with your circle of influence. We love being connected. And hey, for you host homes out there and host homes to be, we're so glad that we get to actually do what we do right here. Now, the Bible instructs us to write the vision,
make it plain,
so those who read it can run with it. So in efforts to keep the vision before you, if you're new to MPC, our vision is to equip you to grow greater in your relationship with God, deeper with your spouse, your family, your friends, and to get closer with others. It's written, and you can read all about it on our MPC Masterpiece Church website. It's right there for you to be able to run with it. And that vision of greater, deeper, and closer, we accomplish this by utilizing this virtual space, us and you together, so that we become the local church wherever you are. Wherever you are. Whether you're a small group, whether you're a host home, we aren't just having church, we're being the church.
Hey.
That's our mission. And it's great that we connected. It's wonderful that a church will meet you right where you are, but our purpose is not to connect you to me and Kristen or to MPC. Our purpose is that during our time together and afterwards, that you get closer to Jesus after our time together. Amen. All right, we're about to go in, y'all. We're in a series called How to Worship the King. How to Worship the King. The King is here. And if you missed last week's message, it's available on demand as well as the other messages. But I got to tell you, go to masterpiecechurch.com. If you're a real one, download the MPC app. You're going to want to have to go back and hear last week's message because this week is a continuation. We're equipping you to go to new levels in worship. And that requires us to not only know what we do in church, but to know the why behind what we're doing. Yeah. So today, we're continuing on in a series with a message called The Power of Music, Part 2. The Power of Music, Part 2. If you would bow your heads and pray with me. God, this is probably one of the toughest messages that you have given me to give to your sons and your daughters. I ask you to allow the Holy Spirit to be my translator. God, show up and speak into the earth what you are saying from heaven. Make me invisible so what your people hear are your words, what they see is your truth, what they feel is your heart for worship, and how to engage in warfare when we don't recognize we're in a fight. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, we're going in. I hope y'all ready?
Buckle up.
All right, previously we discussed three things about music. If you didn't catch last week,
it's
go
a
back.
Series. Previously.
Oh, previously on, yeah. Last week we talked about music has power.
Yeah.
We said that music is a gift from God.
Yep.
And we said that music is the battleground for the soul. You have to go back to understand what that means. But there's a scripture in Colossians chapter 3, verse 16. It says this: let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. Here's what the journey has done. We began this worship journey by first discussing music. This is because most people hear the word worship and immediately our mind goes to music. Yeah. This weekend, we're going to dive even deeper. Sam, you said we can go deep. We're going deeper to understand why it's so important to know how deep worship goes beyond music. You were then introduced and we made you aware of this understanding of something called spiritual influences. In other words, God wants to influence you spiritually. He wants you to lift your hands. He wants you to praise. He wants you to worship in joy and in peace and in healing. The enemy, who is anti-God, he's anti-Christ, his desire is for you. He wants to influence you physically, so that you don't feel joy and you don't feel peace. You don't want to lift your hands. You don't want to worship. And all of these things is where this war is being waged here on the earth. And so understand that music becomes this battleground for what's happening here inside of you, inside of your heart. Whether you know it or not, this musical battleground is real. Yeah. You may not be aware of it, but music is everywhere. Like spiritual influences attach themselves to music. Mm-hmm. Like we just had a worship service here. You just watched it. And what was happening here in the living room is that we charged the atmosphere with God-influenced music and songs. And there's spiritual influences that may make you want to raise your hands. It may make you want to sing. It may make you want to pray, or it may make you want to celebrate because it's influencing you because it's affecting your spirit. On the other hand, if you leave this service and you go pull out Dr. Dre's album, The Chronic, there is drug influence on the music. You'll feel it. If you go pull out an old Montel Jordan record, there is alcohol and party influence on the music. If you go pull up an old Public Enemy album, there's political consciousness influence on the music. If you pull up a Marvin Gaye album, there's social justice, there's sensual, there's sexual influences on the music. If you pull up NWA, Ice Cube, there's gangster, there's street mentality influence. Are y'all picking up what I'm putting down? See, there are spiritual influences that attach itself to the music that's attached to your life soundtrack. And those things are in a battle for who and what you're going to worship while you're here on this earth. I know it may seem like an insignificant thing. It's because many of us are in a spiritual battle and you don't realize you're at war. Being that we're in a battle and we don't even understand, some of us, that we're in this battle, the question becomes, well, if this is a battle, if this is a war, what's the biggest tool in this battle or in this war of music and spirituality? Those tools or those weapons are called songs. Songs are the weapons used in music to fight and to wage war. I don't know if you get this, but worship is warfare. But we'll get into that another day. Here's what I need you to know. Music can affect your mood. Even if you can't replicate the notes or sing them or the rhythm, you rhythmless and you can't remember all the words, you can still recognize the emotion that's conveyed in the music. It's how in a romance that the piano starts playing, or it's how when a baby carriage and you start to hearing certain music. And in just a moment, I'm going to share with you three things that we all need to know about songs, because songs are the way we express music. A lot of people don't know this, but songs are normally comprised of three things. And I want you to know what those three things are. Songs are comprised of a melody, a rhythm, and lyrics. Melody, rhythm, lyrics. Most songs have all three of those elements in it. I mean, if it's a good song, it's supposed to have those three things. But let's discuss this. The first thing that everybody should know about a song deals with the melody, and the melody is the tune of a song. This is a master class right here, I'm telling y'all. Because most people enjoy listening to music, but you are completely oblivious. You are unaware that when you listen to a song, the melody of a song affects your emotions. The melody of a song affects your emotions. Yeah, people are unaware of that melody affects your emotions. Melody is the pitch, the tone, the texture, the loudness, the softness. Our favorite melodies actually release something called dopamine, like a drug. It's a feel-good hormone, and melody, it activates your brain's pleasure and reward system. I know that's deep, but this is a psychological, like it's an actual thing. There's a scripture in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 19 to 20. It says this, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart, giving thanks always and for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. There's a scripture in Proverbs 23 that tells us whatever a person thinks, that's what they become. So understand what's happening is melody goes to work on your mind. And what that in turn does is it influences your heart. I'm going to give you a very, very practical example. Back when I was a kid, I used to watch this TV show called The Incredible Hulk. Mm-hmm. Now, The Incredible Hulk, this is old school here. This is pre-Marvel. This was Lou Ferrigno, the bodybuilder that, you know, used to paint up in green paint. This was a real television series called The Incredible Hulk. And there was this guy, Dr. David Bruce Banner, who was suffering from gamma radiation, and you did not want to make him angry because you wouldn't like him when he's angry. And what would happen every episode, somebody make him angry and he turn into the Hulk and he tear up the entire city. And at the end of the show, you see this dude walking on this lonely road all by himself. And this light piano music would come on and it would say, doom, 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 doom. Dun, 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 dun. And I would think to myself as a kid, man, I feel so sad. Mm-hmm. Poor, lonely man. Guy can't catch a break. Music made me feel sad. By the way, the name of that song I just hummed is The Lonely Man. Let me go a different way, because that might have been too old school for some of y'all. My Nana calls these her stories.
Her job.
There's a show called The Young and the Restless. Yeah. Some of y'all know, even if you ain't never watched it, you know the music. And when that show comes on, you hear this little piano line, this watch this. I don't know about you, but Does that make you feel young and restless? Actually, for some of y'all, you've been watching that for a while, and you're the not so young and restless. You're the seasoned and marinated and restless. another good one. The theme from Rocky. I don't care wherever I am. This movie comes on every time. Okay, listen, I don't care when you put that movie on. If you put it on today, I hear that music, I get pumped, man. I get pumped. I'm telling you, I want to run around the house and just punch somebody in the chest. That's how I feel right now. That's how I feel. Don't come up to me too quick after service, because I'm still coming down off of this. But man, I'm feeling pumped right now. But here's the point. Whether a song makes you feel sad, or it makes you feel young and restless, or it makes you feel pumped, any song that influences the way you feel, it has power over you. Mm. Now, that influence is a spiritual influence that can either glorify God or glorify something else. Melody affects your emotions, what you feel. That's the first thing you need to know about songs. Second thing you need to know about song is the rhythm. The rhythm is gonna get you. Gloria Estefan. The rhythm of a song affects your will. The rhythm of a song affects your will. The rhythm of a song is the beat of a song. And a lot of people are completely unaware. They're oblivious that when you are listening to the rhythm or the beat or the pattern of a song, it affects your will. What do you mean by my will, Pastor Montel? Well, when I say it affects your will, it affects your call to action. It affects your wanting to act or to react, to behave, to move a certain way. It calls you to do something. It calls you into action. And I don't know how many times, I'm sure, and I don't have to stay on this one long because you all will get this, but maybe you've heard a song on the radio or on your playlist, and when the song comes on, you've thought to yourself, man, trash.
Facts. Facts.
Trash. This song is garbage. This song is garbage. How did this song even get on the radio? What three-year-old wrote this song? No disrespect to three-year-olds. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is we've probably all heard a song. You put in the chat if you've heard a song and you've said to myself, what is this? But then, after you listen to it, you hear it a couple more times, what happens?
Grows on you.
It starts to grow on you. It starts to grow on you. Why is that? Because the rhythm or the beat of that song starts to affect your will, your action, your behavior, your movement towards the song. I'll give you an example. Uh-oh. Going back to Dre, one more time, producer Dr. Dre. Then one of the dopest records that to this day is the party anthem, 50 Cent. And I'm going to tell you, if you weren't always saved, you'll understand this. There's a song called In the Club. Bum, bounch, bum, bounch, bum, bounch, bum, bounch, bum, bounch, bum, bounch. Now listen, yeah. Now listen. Thank you. And listen. Now get this. This is so good because I'm not really singing notes. I'm not doing melody. I'm not giving you words. I am giving you beats. And what's happening is I'm giving you a beat. And I heard Janet Jackson say, give me a beat. I'm giving you a beat. And when you hear that beat, something starts to happen. Because the beat or the rhythm starts to affect your will. I could see it in the camp, our crew here, our production. It starts to affect your mood. I think about the movie 8 Mile. Eminem. Eminem, classic song. Oh, Mom, man. Spaghetti. Lose Yourself. Listen, that song comes on. Dun 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 dun. Look at my face. Dun 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 dun. You see my face is dun dun. I can't go dun 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 dun. It doesn't match. Dun dun dun. You can't smile and make that sound. You have to frown.
Yeah.
You have to. Why? Why do you have to? Why do I have to frown? It's because the beat and the rhythm are affecting my will. It affects your action. It affects your behavior. Listen, if I start it and I say, "This is how we do," go. What? Okay. See. Okay. Hold up. See. Listen. Some of y'all almost backslid right there. Camera person almost backslid. It's okay. But you in church. You in church, so we can get healing. We're here for you. There's healing for you. Is there room at the altar? Yes. There is yet room. Why is that? Why does that happen? Why? When that drops in, why is that? Mm-hmm. Why is that? It's because the rhythm and the beat of a song affect your will. It affects your movement, your call to action. It affects your behavior. Mm-hmm. Bae, I thought about this. We were on a summer vacation. We went on a cruise this past summer, the whole family, and a bunch of families. We're all on the upper deck of this cruise ship. Yeah. Joint crowd, 8 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy. Everybody is up there on this cruise ship enjoying the journey.
Facts.
Shout out to Big Daddy Kane. That's a Big Daddy Kane line right there. I'm sorry, Sarah, I'm not talking to you. Thank you. I say something or whatever, and she thinks I'm talking to her. But whenever the DJ would drop certain songs, certain beats, some of the adults started twerking and doing dances
that should not be done in
mixed company.
Facts.
Like, no, but I mean, like, they started gathering around each other and making like a circle, and it got nasty in public. And the MC had to go, "Whoa, whoa, whoa, stop the music, stop. Yo, we can't do that here. Maybe later on we do, but don't do that right now. Don't do that. Now think about this. Why would he have to instruct them not to do that while children were around? Wouldn't it seem obvious that you don't do that when children are around? Why did he have to stop the music? Why did he have to stop? Why did he have to stop it in order to get people to stop what they were doing, as though they didn't know that kids were around? It's inappropriate, not just around kids, and some it's inappropriate. Period. Okay, but it's period. But it's because the rhythm or the beat of a song affects your will. It pulls you in. It draws you in. It compels you. Yep. And here's what you need to know about that. Any song you listen to that affects your will, it influences your will to act, your will to behave, your will to move a certain way. It has power over you. Now, that spiritual influence attached to that song, it may be a beat or whatever. It may be something that makes you want to stand up or worship to God in church and give God glory. Or it could be a beat or a rhythm that makes you not give honor to God and honor something else. It has power over you. I just thought, as a sidebar, spiritually, what does your rhythm look like? Mm. And I said beats are comprised of certain patterns. So what is the beat of your life? What does the pattern of you connecting with God look like? The melody of a song affects your emotions. The rhythm of a song affects your will. This is the third and the last thing I want to talk about. Songs have lyrics. The third thing about song is that the lyrics of a song affect your mind. The lyrics of a song affect your mind. Most people don't know. They don't know that the lyrics of a song affect your mind. The lyrics are words of a song. They have a way of affecting your thinking. And I got to tell y'all, This is tough, because I'm asking God for the grace to deliver this part of the message to you, because I love you. I love you. And I'm sharing this information because it's going to help you. and this is probably going to hurt. This is going to hurt. I'm telling you the truth in love, because some things I'm going to say right now are going to hurt, but I believe God wants you to hear this, because he wants you to know his heart for music, his heart for songs, his heart for worship. And so when we talk about lyrics in particular, when we're talking about words, it's crazy because the lyrics of a song are more important than you could ever comprehend. One of the things we do is we allow our musical icons and our celebrities to minister to us. They become ministers to us. They're not ministers, it's just music, right? It's just songs. A lot of people don't know this, but you don't have to be in church to be a minister of music. You can be a minister of music in the world. In case y'all forgot, you didn't catch this, you missed it in the previous message. The enemy lost his position as head over music in heaven, but his job description never changed in the earth. I know this because that's what I was. I was a minister of music in the world. I could tell you what you're going to do, because I said, this is how we do it. I tell you when we're going to do it, on Friday night. I could tell you how you felt. You feel all right. I could tell you what was going to happen. I could tell you what was going to happen when we got into the club. I can tell you we was going to reach for 40s and turn them up. I could tell you that we're going to lift up our hands from there to there and wave them from here to there. I was allowed to minister to people, and I could make some people feel good. It did a lot of things. So understand, I got to be accountable for the things I said and the things I did. I was ministering to many of you. I would go as far as to say this. A lot of you, I was your minister of music in the world before I was your worship pastor in the church. So here's the question. Who's your minister of music now? Oh. Well, let's examine that. Bet you you'll see far. Bet you see stars. Bet you elevate. Bet you meet God. I feel like falling in love. I'm in the mood to something up. Bet you see God. That's your minister of music. Queen Bey. And listen, Beyonce is your minister of music. And a lot of you don't want to accept that she's your minister of music. And Beyonce don't want to accept the responsibility of being your minister of music. But she is. And I already know. Social media is going to have a field day with this. I know they're going to take a sound bite. I'm going to tell you what you're going to do before you do it. People are going to take a sound bite out of context. And I'm going to have a whole beehive mad at me. And they're not going to post that I said, I love her. I love her. Her creativity, love Beyonce, her family, no, back from the back in the day from Destiny's Child days, always loved her.
Always.
I shared last week that God don't have a problem with kings and queens in the earth.
That's right.
Until we start to worship them. And for some of you, she's not just entertaining you, she's ministering to you. Think about it. Some of you are having a renaissance in your life right now based on her ministry. And the ministry she gives you, that you cuff it, bust it, you a seasoned professional, squeeze it, don't let it go, tease it, no self-control. Yeah, I got time today too. See? Now hold on for a second. We'll talk. Pause for a second. Some of you, you need to ask Holy Spirit right now, why is this making me angry? Why is Montel making me angry right now? You're ingesting these messages into your spirit. And as you take these messages into your spirit, she's ministering to you. If it was just a song, if it was just entertainment, it wouldn't bother you. What I'm saying right now would be nothing. It would mean nothing to you. Why is it bothering you? Because it changes the way you dress. It changes the way you go out. It changes the way you behave. It changes your swagger. It changes your movement. It changes everything. Because of that music and because of that message, it will compel you to feel and to act and to think a certain way. And right now, Pastor Montel is messing with your idols. But I need you to get this. Idols don't build themselves. We build them. If you can't say amen, say ouch. Either one works. And so what that means is what I'm saying, this ain't even about Beyonce. This ain't about Queen Bey. This is about you. Yeah. This is about what you've done. Yeah. Yeah, no milk today, baby. This is all meat. We're at war. Yeah. I've laid a foundation that we are at war and you're getting your teeth kicked in and you don't realize you're in a fight. Mm. I'm a dad, man. Mm. I'm a dad. I was present for the births of my children. Boys and girls that have gender. It is my responsibility because I was there as a good father to impart identity into my children. But I have to compete with their worship pastors. Oh, you're missing this. Going back, my girl Katy Perry, she tell them, I kissed a girl and I liked it. I kissed a girl and I liked it. The taste of her cherry lipstick. I kissed a girl and I liked it. But hey, that's just a choice that anybody can make, right? Girl Cardi B telling them, there's some whores in this house. There's some whores in this house. But no, that's empowerment now. That's women taking control of their own narrative. Boy, Lil Wayne back in the day, lick it like a lollipop. Lick it like a lollipop. Yeah. Does that disturb you when I say that? Why? What does that disturb? Why does that disturb? What's the problem with me? Listen, Lady Gaga tell you, don't be a drag, be a queen. I was born this way. These are your ministers of music. It's not just entertainment. And I got to repeat the stuff that ain't going to get posted. I'm not against any of these artists.
Love them.
Idols don't create themselves. When we reposition a person into that space that affects our mind, our will, and our emotions, we enter a worship space. And songs are the weapons on this battlefield of music for your soul. And we're ingesting ministry into us that's determining who we are. So I ain't coming for Beyonce. I'm not coming for Katy Perry's because I did it too. I'm not coming for me. What I'm saying to you is there's an underlying war, y'all. There is a war, and music is the battleground. And these songs are used as weapons. And those toting the weapons or providing the weapons may not even know that they're in battle, but they are delivering warfare to us. When I was just saying that old Lil Wayne record, lick it like a lollipop, saying it over and over, here's what's happening. Here's what's happening. You're ingesting and repeating repetitively information, a message over and over again, like I did 50 years ago. You remember when I started out with the message earlier about repeating things over and over again that become a part of who I am? And 50 years later, word for word, it's a part of me. That for you, many of you watching right now, even in this room, what are you going to repeat 10, 20, 30, 40 years from now? And it's the perfect storm. This is how it happens. The perfect storm. When you have that song and the melody, oh, it just has that right feeling. The beat of that song, that joint, oh my goodness, it affects your will. It affects how you act, how you behave, how you move. But the lyrics, you couldn't have done better if you wrote it yourself. The words hit you right in that spot that says, man, that's exactly what I was thinking. And it's dealing with what you are dealing with at the time. And so it affects your mind. It affects the way you think. And the word of God says, whatever a person thinks in his heart, that's what he is. That's who she is. And so here's what's happened. Follow me, y'all. The melody hits the emotions. The rhythm hits your call to action, your will. The lyrics are saying exactly what you were thinking, and it's created the perfect atmosphere, and you actually are in a place of worship. But worship only happens at church. No. You go to a place of worship all week long. But you think it's just music. It's just music. It's just a song, right? No. All week long, you're worshiping. And let me tell you why I know this. Because every weekend, as churches like MPC and your church probably all over America, all over the world, worship leaders are preparing to set an atmosphere where God is prepared for you to enter the presence of the Lord. And that team gets about 15 to 20 minutes every weekend, depending on if you get there on time. They got 15 to 20 minutes to try and grab you and bring your spirit into the presence of God. Some of you kicking and screaming, you got to be dragged into the presence of God. You don't stand, you don't move, you don't lift your hand. You go in a club, your joint comes on, you go in. You go on TikTok and you dance for strangers, but you get in the presence of God and you don't feel like worshiping. Listen, we have to bring some of y'all out there. I'm not talking about, but some of y'all, we got to drag you into the presence of God just to experience the living God and encounter with God just for a few minutes so we can try and counter what your other worship pastors have been feeding you all week long. You've had 6 days, 23 hours, and 40 minutes of whatever you wanted to worship to, and we get 20 minutes because your worship pastors are feeding you the stuff you're consuming all week long. It's hard to compete with that. That 20 minutes, it's hard to compete with that. Here's the point, though. Any song that causes or influences you to feel or act or think a certain way, it has power over you. So, what do you do with that? What do you do with that? Timothy, 2 Timothy, chapter 3. Verses 1 through 5. But understand this, that in the last days, there will come times of difficulty. For people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, proud, arrogant, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy. Unholy. Heartless. Unappeasable, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not loving good, treacherous, reckless, swollen with conceit, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having the appearance of godliness, but denying its power. Oh, avoid such people. Personal testimony. There are some comedians that I thoroughly enjoy, but I cannot expose the God in me to that worship anymore. Personal decision. But you could say, but I mean, it's just comedy. It's just jokes, right? There are some shows, some series, some Netflix and whatever specials that I really wanted to finish. Mm-hmm. But we watch it happen, y'all, where you watching a show and then the content takes a hard left. Yeah. And then I'm forced with this decision of forcing the Holy Spirit inside of me to sit through my choice. But it's just a show, right? Some of my favorite artists, some of y'all watching this, some of my favorite artists, I have to try and find an edited version of your project because I love you and I love what you do. And honestly, some of y'all, I just can't ride with you like that anymore. And please hear me. This ain't, it doesn't mean I'm writing you off. It doesn't mean I'm canceling you. It's not cancel. It means I'm taking you off the pedestal of being a king or queen of my soul. I'm not canceling you. I'm un-idling you. That's not a word, but it should be. I'm un-idling you. That space is reserved for Jesus and Jesus alone. Let me tell you, if you think the throne of your heart can be shared with any other God or minister of music, you have allowed yourself to be fooled into believing a lie. You're a part of the 33%. You're a part of the third. How could Lucifer convince a third of angels to leave paradise, to leave heaven? It's because the enemy is influential. He's persuasive. He's convincing. He's beautiful. He's empowering. And he's a liar. He did it then, and he's doing it now. Look at this, 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 11 through 15. God knows that I do love you, but I'll go on doing what I'm doing. This will take away the opportunity of those people who want to brag because they think they're like us. Watch this. People who brag like this are false prophets, false apostles. They are dishonest workers since they disguise themselves as Christ's apostles. And no wonder. Even Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. So it's not surprising if his servants also disguise themselves as servants who have God's approval. In the end, they will get what they deserve. It's a great place to break. Great place to pause. I told you, dun, dun, dun.
Man.
It's a place to pause and reflect on where we are after this second power of music message. I shared with you three things about music, three things about songs. And what I've shared can be, it's challenging for you to process. I know it. I know it's tough. I became a pastor because I didn't want to disguise myself as a servant who had God's approval. I want to be a servant with God's approval. No pretending. Jay-Z said, no, not Jay. He's not for play. Montel, not for play. But maybe today, you can determine if you want to take that mask off. Remove the disguise, man. What am I saying? Pretend holiness ain't going to work. Part-time salvation, it's not going to cut it. Are y'all starting to see why worship is more than a song? Like, we're talking about movies, film. Like it's more than a song. But we are equipping you to worship the King. Not a King.
The King.
The King.
It's different.
And God does not have a problem with kings and queens in the earth. They have authority. Until we start worshiping them. I'm going to finish this message next week. I'm going to finish Power of Music next week. Part three. I'm going to ask you. Share this with some other people that you know need to hear it. Maybe even go back and listen to it yourself to understand what God is speaking to you. And please, like I said, the stuff that won't get posted, this is not a hate message. This is not a cancellation message. This is an awareness message so that whatever decision you make moving forward, at least you know what God thinks about it. And G.I. Joe said, knowing is half the battle. Yes.
I'm sure I'm not the only person that has this question. I'm sure many of you have this question. So based on the information that we've heard over the last 2 weeks, I would imagine you're not suggesting one has to listen to purely only Christian music and purely only this. So how does someone who maybe is trying to now, you know, I realize like, oh man, maybe some of that applied to me and maybe, mm-hmm. you know, a hit dog a dollar. How do you suggest that someone start to make those transitions? Because what I do know is if you take something away but don't fill it,
right.
it's still a void.
Right.
And so then that something else can come and compete for that space. So what is your recommendation or how would you go about advising someone of kind of transitioning into more, not necessarily, you know, 100% Christian music, but like, is there a way to listen to secular music without it stealing your soul and dragging you to hell? What do you do? How do I remove the gasoline draws on the way down? What do you do?
Listen, I got you. And Power Music Part 3. What you just asked, I'm going to answer that next week. I promise you, I'm going to answer that next week. I started out this message and I said, by the time we get done with this entire series, you're going to have to make a decision. And all we're doing is presenting things to you. We're basically letting you know that you're in a fight, that there's a war going on. And as I present these things to you, eventually the question you're asking is, okay, well, I'm in a battle. How do I win this fight? Next week, I'm going to give you the tools that you're going to need to know what you need to do. That's good. You got to come back next week now. I'm telling you, yo, this is fire. This is fire. Let me tell you what God thinks about you just real quick as we close this out. God thinks you're to die for. So he did. He sent his only son, Jesus Christ, to die on Calvary, a cross that should have been ours. But he did it so that you can have eternal life. So you can have eternal life. And you have that because if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth that he's the Son of God and he was raised from the dead, you have eternal life. You have eternity in paradise with the Father. And so if you want to accept the King of Kings as your Lord and your Savior today, I'm going to ask you to say a prayer with me. Listen, the prayer is not a finish line. It's a starting point for a new relationship with Jesus Christ. And perhaps some of you want to return to Christ today. Maybe you've made that choice. You made that decision before, but man, life be life. And maybe you're apart from God. I want you to know he's ready to receive you back today. It'll be the best decision you have ever made in your life. Let me listen. I'm a living witness. I was a dead man. And Jesus Christ has given me new life. I was a sinner and I needed saving. I was directing. I'm passionate about this. I was directing a lot of people towards eternity apart from God. Some people call it hell. You can call it hell. Hell in the next life, hell in this life. Eternity apart from God is hell. And so now I'm simply doing my part to redirect you towards eternity in paradise with the living God. That's you. You want to see Jesus today as your Lord and Savior or return to him. Will you pray with me? Let's bow our heads. God, thank you. Thank you for revealing yourself to us, not just in talking about music and songs and these things, God, but you are teaching us that we have to worship you in spirit and in truth. The truth part is what we can see in the natural. It doesn't seem like it's that serious, but in spirit and in truth, our eyes and our hearts are being awakened to a spiritual realm, a spiritual warfare that we may not recognize is happening. And so right now, as you are opening us to what you are saying to us about worshiping you as opposed to worshiping the other things, you have brothers and sisters, you have sons and daughters here who want to receive Jesus Christ. They want to receive you as Lord and Savior. If that's you today, I'm going to ask you, if you repeat this prayer after me, use your mouth, because when you speak, you're actually creating. You're creating, and we're most like God when we are creating. And so let's create this space with him right now. Just say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I love you.
I love you.
You love me first.
You love me first.
You love me more.
You loved me more.
I'm a sinner.
I'm a sinner.
I need a Savior.
I need a Savior.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
You're my Savior.
You are my Savior.
You came to this world.
You came into this world.
For me.
For me.
You died on a cross.
You died on a cross.
For me.
For me.
You went to the grave.
You went to the grave.
For me.
For me.
But you rose again.
But you rose again.
For me.
For me.
So I repent of my sins.
I repent of my sins.
I turn from my old ways.
I turn from my old ways.
I turn to you.
And I turn towards you.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Drive out any darkness.
Drive out any darkness.
Replace it with your love.
Replace it with your love.
Be my Lord and Savior.
Be my Lord and Savior.
All the days of my life.
Days of my life.
If you are able, I'm going to ask you to lift your hands, no matter where you are. If you have the ability to do it, will you lift your hands? Uplifted hands. It's a universal sign of surrender. Anybody you're going to, well, hands are lifted. I surrender. I give up. And maybe you are surrendering your life. You're surrendering your will to the Father today. Maybe you're surrendering sickness. You could be surrendering disease. You could be surrendering disbelief. You could be surrendering anger or bitterness. You could be surrendering anything. Because you're in the presence of God, you could surrender that to him today and he'll receive it. He's the only one worthy to receive it because he paid the price for it. He picked up the tab. And uplifted hands is also a universal sign of receiving. And maybe right now you're receiving salvation. You could be receiving healing. You could be receiving love. You could be receiving forgiveness. You could be receiving peace right now. And it doesn't matter if you're surrendering or you're receiving. Just know that God met you here today in the midst of a message to let you know that you belong to him and that he died for you and he'd do it again and again. So we should live for him. And we receive that in Jesus' name. Everybody said amen. 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 Come on, can we just celebrate for a moment? Just say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, if you gave your life to Jesus Christ, I want to let you know it's the best decision that you will ever make. One of the most important decisions anyone will ever make. And so we want to celebrate you. If you did that, put it in the chat, first of all. We want to know because our leaders are there to celebrate and let you know that they're proud of you. And next, go one more step. And would you text SAVED? Text SAVED to 24365. And what happens when you do that, it'll give you a prompt and a link for us to be able to walk alongside of you so that, hey, I said the prayer, Pastor, what do I do now? It's going to give you a step-by-step process of your new walk in faith with Jesus Christ. MPC, we're coming alongside of you. We're not leaving you out there. We're walking with you to know what to do next. If you're giving, text GIVING to 24365. It's 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. We're here and we bought that life. Hey, thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your faithfulness, your tithe, your offering, your gifts. We appreciate it. We need it because we are trying to expand the kingdom. We're taking territory for the kingdom of heaven, and you allow us to be able to take the gospel of Jesus Christ into all the earth. And so thank you for texting GIVING to 24365. Lastly, if you need anything else, you want to talk to a leader, you want prayer, you need materials or resources for your marriage, whatever else you need, text MPC to 24365. We are here for you and we have leaders on standby ready to help you in whatever way we can serve you. Hey, if you need that merch,
bam,
you know what it is. Look up, come on. Come on, y'all. You need that merch. Yo, I'm going to tell you where to go. Go to mpcdrip.com. That's right. mpcdrip.com. We experienced it here online. Now you got to take it offline and live it. That's what I'm doing. That's what we're doing. We're living it day to day. Thank you to our host homes, our living rooms, all our leaders out there, wherever you are, that's been carrying MPC with you. We love you. Hey, share this message. Share it. It's on demand. You know, let's get it. Whoever God wants it to reach, it'll reach. And I'm so glad that I need you to stay locked and loaded, because it's not done yet. Like I said, this was part two. You don't want to leave on just part two. Trust me, I'm gonna clear up some things in part three, and you're going to be able to know how to win this war. All right? Like, share, subscribe. We'll see you in the virtual lobby.
Amen.
Amen.
See you soon.
Amen. Thank you.